inspire myself a little bit. I've got a very addictive personality, and when I set my goal sights on something, I don't like falling short, and I don't like getting beaten. I don't like getting outdone, and I think that's something that's always driven me. Like, if someone catches a better wave than me, I would want to go out and catch a better wave than them. There's been a lot of struggles to get to where I am today. This year in particular has been a big struggle. This is the first year I've fully committed to the stand-up paddleboarding, and I've kind of put everything else kind of on the back burner. And at the start of this year, I was without a major sponsor. So even getting to events, I remember I worked all summer last year and paid, I think I spent every cent I had to get to the first two events this year to make enough money to go to the next one. I think I first stood on a paddleboard, stand-up paddleboard, about 12. I saw someone out here doing it one time, and at the time, the guy who's making my surf paddleboards was making boards, and I tried one, and then I loved it, and I just went on from there, I guess. Molokai to Oahu paddleboard race is always a big one on our calendar, and it's 52Ks, and it goes from one island to the other. It's always a big emotional rollercoaster, that race, leading up, the preparation, the mental challenge of going from one island, paddling across the channel in the middle of the ocean to the other. And out there by yourself, you always seem to go through so many ups and downs with emotions. It's an addictive feeling, I think, finishing something that you've worked so hard for. But it's always, yeah, you always know you're going to go through some tough times. There's always scary times out in the ocean. I think the worst ones have always been when I've been training it by myself. I think looking back on situations, I find them scary in the ocean. I think right there at that moment, I kind of don't think about it. I think it's something you look back after and you're like, oh, maybe I shouldn't have done that. My regular training regime kind of varies a lot throughout the year. We do a lot of travels, so I'm away, probably works out to be 4 or 5 months each year, so a lot of time on the road, and we race about, or can be up to 20 times a year. So there's a lot of competition, a lot of travelling, and it's, so my training schedule varies a fair bit. When I'm in a full training block, probably be on the water twice a day and then in the gym and running, but it's always hard to train and keep fit while you travel. That's always a bit of a challenge in our sport. People that influence me most would be people like Jamie Mitchell, big wave surfer, paddleboarders, Kyle Lenny, guys that have followed their dream and have tried to do all the things they love, have tried to make that a career, and I think if I could do that, I'd be beyond happy.